Hello, everybody. Today is the day I'm going to tackle my bookshelves and get and my mantle and get it done. So I thought that this would be a good way to show you how I decorate my mantles and my bookshelves. So the first thing I do is I put up my colors that I really want to focus on, and I put them in a zigzag shape. As you notice, over here it goes a zigzag, and then over here it has a zigzag also. And so that is what I do first. Now they might move on the shelves when I put other things up, but those are the colors I'm trying to bring out in these shelves. Now I want to say too that, you know, I might decorate different than other people decorate, and so, but this is the way I do it, and it seems to work really well for me. So now I start putting layering on, trying to layer, and what I mean layering is putting like books down or trays down, so when I put things on top of them, they stand up a little taller. Because what you want to have is something tall and then kind of round it out to something short. And you'll see what I mean as I go on. But this is a layering I'm starting with. It might change once I start putting other things on it. But now I'm going to put some greenery out and see if that what that does.
Okay,
so I'm still working. I put out some greenery, put out some candles. And now I have some vases out that plants or flowers are going to go in. I just haven't done them yet. So I'm just going to keep going and adding things to my shelf until I like it. So as you can tell, I've been working, trying to get them look nice. So far, I'm happy with most of it, not all of it. There's some that don't look good at all, like the one with the F and the green base. That one doesn't look good at all. And there's just some other ones. So you just have to keep working at it. I'm putting filler in there, I'm putting books to make things higher, or a tray to make things look higher, and you just have to keep working with it. It's sometimes it's hard with white backgrounds, because you feel like you can't put too much white up there, but you just keep working with it and it will come together. So I'll be back in a few minutes. So I'm ready to show you how I got my shelves done. So I'm going to take you on a tour. I'm just going to span back here and show you how they look at first. And I think that it turned out pretty, pretty nice. I really like it a lot. So now I'm going to take you in and show you how it looks closer. So as you can see, I did a lot of layering. I put a lot of books up there with stuff on them. And I tried to just make it look really nice, layered with flowers in there, with greenery in there, with pictures of the family, which always I think helps with shells. But I think that it turned out really, really nice. I really like it. And then my mantle, I think my mantle turned out very, very nice. I really like these mantles. I found the vases at TJ Maxx and this little bird on a book at Joann's. And then I got the flowers and the tree stems. I got those at Walmart. And then over here is this shelf. And you know, I don't like every single shelf, but I can always move things around and make them better. I did buy, this is one of the new things I bought, was this clock, and I really like it. I think it just looks really pretty in there. And a lot of this stuff came from Joann's and from Hobby Lobby. But I think everything turned out really, really nice. I really like it. So yeah, I'm just really happy with how this turned out. I think it just makes the living room look really nice. Tell me if you think I have too much up there, or if there's things that need to be moved around. I like to hear from other people. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cabinets and shelves in my living room, dining room area. And this is in the dining room. It's the shiplap on the back, and then this is an old cabinet that was my great-grandmother's, and I filled it with stuff. I found these plates. I don't know if you can see how pretty those are, that my mother had. She didn't even know that, my mom didn't even know that she had them. And so I thought those would look really pretty. It kind of has a dark blue, and they're just beautiful. And they're probably from Scotland, because that's where my grandmother was from. Yeah, it says England on it. But they are just really, really pretty. And so I put mostly white stuff in here with it. And then on the top, an old window with some magnolia leaves and some flowers and a clock and stuff that I just think has turned out really pretty for this room. I really like it. And then don't know if you can see that. I can't really see it. The light's just really shining. I got this sign from one of my daughters for Christmas, which I really love. And over here is my dining room cabinet that I redid. And I think it looks really nice. I have a lot of old things in here. Like one of my grandmother's dishes set, an old house, just some old things that have been in our family for a while. That was my grandmother's very old, applesauce maker. And I thought, well, that should be up and not just sitting in a closet. And some old rolling pins. And so I think these shelves turned out really nice. I put my cookbooks in a little wire basket. And I have some pictures of kids back there. I think I'm probably going to take them and put them up higher, put them on the wall. But I haven't got to that yet. I'm waiting. I need new pictures of all the grandkids. And then there's another old set. It was one of my great-grandmother's. And just some other stuff that I have up in there that really stand out. And the top ones, I have lights in the top ones. I'm gonna put some more lights in because I think it needs more lights. But I think that this turned out really nice. I'm really happy with it. I do have more things to put up. As you can tell, I have an old scale to hang up on the from the ceiling. I'm gonna get that up. I did get one of these mail envelopes to put flowers in, and then I have these cute cherry plates that I want to put up. And so, yeah, I do have more to do. So this is look from the living room. This is stuff I'm still working on. I still have where I'm just trying to decide where to put these two baskets on the wall. And these are picture frames that I'm going to put in my hallway. And then those are more flowers to work with. But I think that all in all, my dining room looks really pretty. Here's a view of it from one side. Here's a view from the other side. And I just think that the dining room just looks really pretty. I really am happy with how it looks. Let's see if the light makes it look better. I don't know if the light will make it look any better. But yeah, I'm really happy with how that shelf came out. And then on my dining room table, I decided I'm gonna go behind, see if it looks better. I put just a runner with a basket and a couple candles. Yeah, and I still need to take the name tag, the price tag off. But I think that my dining room looks really pretty. I'm really happy with it. And then if you look in the living room, I'm getting there. Yeah, we moved in last year, and I still have a lot to do around here, but you know, it's getting done. I'm not sure about my living room furniture. I am trying to figure out if it really fits in here or if I should put it in the family room downstairs. The rug isn't really what I want for my living room. It looks more like a family room rug, but yeah, it's coming together, and I'll get there. So thank you for watching this, and I'll see you later. Please hit the subscribe button so you can see more of what I'm going to be doing in my house. And please do a thumbs up if you like this video. And please leave me a message below if you see anything that I need to change. or what you're feeling about how I decorate. I would love to see what you have to say. And again, thank you for watching, and see you next time. Bye.